In this short little tutorial, we're going to be talking about real roots. Now, a root is the solution to an equation, but I'm only going to be talking about square roots. And what does it mean for it to be a real number? Well, a real number is simply a number that's on the number line. Pretty straightforward, right? Well, let's go ahead and draw a number line and play with some square roots. There's our number line, and there's our square roots. Well, let's see what they are and see if they're on the number line. Well, square root of 9, that's going to be 3. That's because 3 times 3 is 9. It could also be negative 3. Negative 3 times negative 3. Negative times a negative is a positive. That's also going to be 9. Well, square root of 16, that's going to be 4, because 4 times 4 is 16. And negative 4, because negative 4 times negative 4 is also positive 16. Negative times a negative. Now, they are on the number line. 3 and negative 3. There's 4 and negative 4. Well, what about the square root of 10? Well, that should be in between the 9 and the 16. And it's actually an irrational number. It's a decimal. It goes on and on and on forever. But it's still on the number line. It's somewhere between the 3 and the 4. 3.16, it's a little bit beyond the 3. But remember, negative times a negative is a positive. It's also negative 3.162277, on and on. And that's also on the number line somewhere. These are all real numbers. These are real square roots. Let's try one more. Well, the square root of 4 is something you guys all know. It's 2. That's because 2 times 2 is 4. And it's also going to be negative 2. Because negative 2 times negative 2 is also 4. Negative times a negative is a positive. And it's going to be on the number line, 2 and negative 2. Here's the problem. What if it's the square root of a negative number? The square root of negative 4. Well, can we think of something that would work? 2 times 2? No, it's positive 4. Negative 2 times negative 2, we tried that before. Negative times a negative is not going to be negative, it's going to be positive. Here's the big problem. There is no number on the number line, the whole number line, that is the square root of negative 4. There is no real square root. It's an imaginary number. Imaginary numbers are something that you'll play with later in your math classes. They have no real root. So when you come across one of these things with the square root of a negative number, when you're trying to solve, you're not going to be able to find a real root. So just to reiterate, just to recap, if there's a negative sign under the radical, then it has no real roots. There's nothing there that's going to be on the number line, and they're said to be imaginary. So I hope this helps, and good luck.